Shemay, in previous videos, we have discussed the plot function in detail. This is useful for making two-dimensional scatter or line plots. But there are a number of other plot types available. We will survey some of them here. Think of all of these as tools in your tool belt in your ongoing mission of presenting data more powerfully. The polar function plots data in polar coordinates. Most of us are very familiar with Cartesian or rectangular coordinates, where two dimensions define the horizontal movement and the vertical movement. With polar coordinates, the two dimensions are distance from the origin and angle, with the angle being measured counterclockwise starting at the positive x-axis. Polar plots often utilize the trigonometric functions like sine, trace the path of rotational or orbital behavior, and simply look pretty. You will likely explore these in detail in Calculus 2 or beyond. The functions stem and stairs are alternative forms of 2D scatter plots. As shown here, stem places the scatter points just like normal, but then draws vertical lines from the x-axis up to each scatter point. Stairs places each scatter point, then draws a horizontal and vertical line to connect each of the dots. Bar plots are very commonly used to represent simple 2D data. The function bar produces the standard version of a bar plot, with bars extending vertically from the x-axis. The H in bar H stands for horizontal. As you can see, the axes here are flipped, and so the bars extend horizontally. Now we get to this delicious segment of the presentation, pie charts. These are very useful to show relative proportions within a population. There are a number of different syntaxes available, with three examples shown here. For the most basic use, the only input argument needed is a vector containing amounts that fall under different categories. MATLAB will then size the slices proportionally and write the percentage next to each slice. Instead of percentages, we can have names for each slice. For this, we need a cell array containing the names to write within single quotes. This works much like the legend function. Each entry within the names array corresponds with an entry in the same position in the data vector. Another interesting option is called explode. With this, we can emphasize certain slices of data by splitting them out of the main pie. To cause this, create a vector of ones and zeros with ones corresponding to the slices you want to explode. In this example, the slices corresponding with the 2 and 5 data are separated from the main pie. The compass plot works much like a bar or a stem plot, with one big exception. The horizontal axis is now a rotational axis. Instead of reading left to right, it is measured in degrees moving counterclockwise from the positive x-axis. This is useful for plotting data that physically comes from different directions. One example would be measuring wind direction at a weather tower. The final example we'll survey here is the histogram, made with the hist function. You will study histograms extensively in statistics courses. They show the frequency of events falling into different categories, or bins. In the top example, I first create my data set as 10,000 random numbers from the normal distribution. Then I made a histogram of 15 bins. MATLAB automatically parses the x-axis into 15 same-sized chunks. As we can see, the most common bin was right in the center, so the random numbers more often fell between negative 0.3 and positive 0.3. For more manual control, we can define the bin placement explicitly. This vector x goes from negative 3 to positive 3 in steps of 0.1. So there will be a bin for values from negative 3 to negative 2.9, another bin for negative 2.9 to negative 2.8, and so on. There was a fair amount of data that fell below negative 3. All of that gets lumped into one category, shown as this large lump at the end. A word of encouragement. Whenever you read a paper or article or watch a presentation, pay attention to what plots are being used. Ask yourself, why choose a bar chart rather than a scatter plot? Would a pie chart make more sense here? And so on. Doing this will make you a better communicator and a better engineer.